In 2006, the world's greatest piece of fanfiction was written. Consider this, the feature-length adaptation. Part 1 of 2, part 2 coming soon. Featuring Sorrow TV. So turn off the lights. Get comfy. It's story time. My Immortal. Hi, my name is Ebony Darkness Dementia Ravenway. And I have long ebony black hair. That's how I got my name. I'm a vampire, but my teeth are straight and white. I'm also a witch, and I go to a magic school called Hogwarts in England, where I'm in the 7th year. I'm a goth, and I wear mostly black. I love Hot Topic, and I buy all my clothes from there. A lot of preps stare at me. I put up my middle finger at them.
Hey, Ebony! I shouted.
I looked up. It was Draco Malfoy. What's up, Draco? I asked.
Nothing, I said shyly.
But then, I heard my friends call me, and I had to go away. Chapter 2. Author's note. Thanks to Bloody Tears 666 again for helping me with the chapter. By the way, prep stop flaming my story, okay? The next day, I woke up in my bedroom. I opened the door of my coffin and drank some blood from a bottle I had. I got out of my coffin and took off my giant My Chemical Romance t-shirt, which I use for pajamas. Instead, I put on a black leather dress, a pentagram necklace, combat boots, and black fishnets. I put on 4 pairs of earrings in my pierced ears and put my hair in a kind of messy bun. My friend Willow, author's note, Raven, this is you, woke up and then grinned at me. She put on her Marilyn Manson t-shirt with a black mini, fishnets, and pointy high-heeled boots. We put on our makeup, black lipstick, white foundation, and black eyeliner.
OMFG, I saw you talking to Draco Malfoy yesterday, I said excitedly.
Yeah, so, I said, blushing.
Do you like Draco?
I asked as we went out of the Slytherin common room and into the Great Hall.
No, I so f***ing don't, I shouted.
Yeah, right, I exclaimed.
Just then, Draco walked up to me.
Hi, I said.
Hi, I replied flirtily.
Guess what, I said.
What, I asked.
Well, good Charlotte are having a concert in Hogsmeade. I told her.
Oh my f***ing god, I screamed. I love Good Charlotte. They are my favorite band besides My Chemical Romance.
Well, do you want to go with me? I asked.
I gasped. Chapter 3, author's note. Stop flaming the story, preps, okay? Otherwise, Fangs to the Gothics people for the good reviews. Fangs again, Raven. On the night of the concert, I put on my black lace-up boots and high heels. Underneath, there were ripped red fishnets. Then I put on this black mini-dress with all of this corset stuff. I put on matching fishnets on my arms. I straightened my hair and made it look all spiky. I felt a little depressed then, so I slid open one of my wrists.
Oh my god!
As you do. I read a depressing book while I waited for it to stop bleeding, and I listened to some Good Charlotte. I painted my nails black and put on tons of black eyeliner. Then I put on some black lipstick. I didn't put on foundation because I was pale anyway. I drank some human blood, so I was ready to go to the concert. I went outside. Draco was waiting there in front of his flying car. He was wearing a Simple Plan t-shirt. They would play at the show too. Baggy black skater pants, black nail polish, and a little eyeliner. Author's note. A lot for cool boys were it okay. What?
Hi, Draco, I said in a depressed voice.
Hi, Ebony, I said back. We walked into my flying black Mercedes-Benz, the license plate said 666, and flew to the place with the concert. On the way, we listened excitedly to Good Charlotte and Marilyn Manson. We both smoked cigarettes and drugs. When we got there, we both hopped out of the car. We went to the mosh pit at the front of the stage and jumped up and down as we listened to Good Charlotte.
Joel is so fucking hot, I said to Draco, pointing to him as he sang, filling the club with his amazing voice. Suddenly, Draco looked sad. What's wrong? I asked as we moshed to the music. Then I caught on. Hey, it's okay. I don't like him better than you, I said.
Really? I asked sensitively as I put my arm around her all protective.
Really? I said. Besides, I don't even know Joel, and he's going out with Hillary f***ing Duff. I f***ing
f***ing hate that little bitch, I said disgustedly, thinking of her ugly blonde face.
The night went on really well, and I had a great time. So did Draco. After the concert, we drank some beer and asked Benji and Joel for their autographs and photos with them. We got good Charlotte concert tees. Draco and I crawled back into the Mercedes-Benz, but Draco didn't go back into Hogwarts. Instead, he drove the car into the Forbidden Forest.
Chapter 4. I said, stop flaming, okay? Ebony's name is Inobi, not Mary Sue, okay? Draco is so in love with her that he is acting different. They knew each other before, okay? Draco, I shouted, what the f*** do you think you're doing?
Draco didn't answer, but he stopped the flying car, and he walked out of it. I walked out of it too, curiously.
What the f***ing hell, I asked angrily.
Ebony? He asked.
What? I snapped.
Draco leaned in extra close, and I looked into his gothic red eyes. He was wearing color contacts, which revealed so much depressing sorrow and evilness. And then suddenly, I didn't feel mad anymore. And then, suddenly, just as I... Draco kissed me passionately! Draco climbed on top of me, and we started to make out keenly against a tree. He took off my top, and I took off his clothes. I even took off my bra. Then he put his thingy into my you-know-what, and we did it for the first time. Dear God.
Oh, I screamed. I was beginning to get an orgasm. I started to kiss everywhere, and my pale body became all warm. And then...
What the hell are you doing, motherfuckers?
It was Dumbledore. Chapter 5. Author's note. Stop flaming. If you flame, it means you are prep or a poser. The only reason Dumbledore swore is because he had a headache, okay? And on top of that, he was mad at them for having sex. P.S. I'm not updating until I get 5 good reviews. Dumbledore made, and Draco and I follow him. He kept shouting us angrily.
You ludicrous fools! I shouted.
I started to cry, tears of blood down my pallid face. Draco comforted me. When we went back to the castle, Dumbledore took us to Professor Snape and Professor McGonagall, who were both looking very angry.
They were having sexual intercourse in the Forbidden Forest, he yelled in a furious voice.
Why did you do such a thing, you mediocre dunces? Asked Professor McGonagall.
How dare you? Demanded Professor Snape.
And then Draco shrieked, Because I love her!
Everyone was quiet. Dumbledore and Professor McGonagall still looked mad, but Professor Snape said,
Fine. Very well. You may go up to your rooms.
Draco and I went upstairs, while the teachers glared at us.
Are you okay, Ebony?
Draco asked gingerly.
Yeah, I guess. I lied. I went to the girls' dorm and brushed my teeth and my hair and changed into a low-cut, black floor-length dress with red lace all around it that had black high heels. When I came out, Draco was standing in front of the bathroom. He had started to sing, I Just Want to Live by Good Charlotte. I was so flattered, even though he wasn't supposed to be there. We hugged and kissed. After that, we said goodnight, and he reluctantly went back to his room. Chapter 6. Shut up, preps, okay? P.S. I won't update until you give me good reviews. The next day I woke up in my coffin. I put on a black miniskirt that was ripped all around the edges, and a matching top with red skulls all over it and high-heeled boots that were black. I put on 2 pairs of skull earrings and 2 crosses in my ears. I spray-painted my hair with purple. In the Great Hall, I ate some Count Chocula cereal with blood instead of milk. And a glass of red blood. Suddenly, someone bumped into me. All the blood spilled all over my top. Bastard, I shouted angrily. I regretted saying it when I looked up. I was looking into the pale white face of a gothic boy with spiky black hair and red streaks in it. He was wearing so much eyeliner that it was going down his face, and he was wearing black lipstick. He didn't have glasses anymore, and now he was wearing red contact lenses just like Draco's, and there was no scar on his forehead anymore. He had a manly stubble on his chin. He had a sexy English accent. He looked exactly like Joel Madden. He was so sexy that my body went all hot when I saw him, kind of like an erection, only I'm a girl, so I didn't get one, you sicko.
I'm so sorry, I said in a shy voice.
That's all right. What's your name? I questioned.
My name's Harry Potter, although most people call me Vampire these days, I grumbled.
Why? I exclaimed.
Because I love the taste of human blood, I giggled.
Well, I am a vampire, I confessed.
Really? I whimpered.
Yeah, I roared. We sat down for a while, then Draco came up behind me and told me he had a surprise for me, so I went away with him. Chapter 7. Bring Me to Life. Author's note. Well, okay guys, I'm only writing this because I got 5 god reviews. And by the way, I won't write next chapter till I get 10 good vons. Stop flaming or I'll report you. Ebony isn't a Mary Sue, okay? She isn't perfect. She's a Satanist. She has problems and she's depressed for God's sake. Draco and I held our pale, white hands with black nail polish and went upstairs. I was wearing red Satanist sings on my nails in red nail polish. Author's note. See, does dat sound like a Meru Sue to you? I waved to Vampire. I guess he was jealous of me, that I was going out with Draco. Anyway, I went upstairs excitedly with Draco. We went to his room, and I locked the door. Then, we started Frenching passively. Then we took off each other's clothes enthusiastically. He felt me up before I took off my top. Then I took off my black leather bra, and he took off his pants. We went on the bed and started making out naked. Then he put his boy's thingy in mine, and we had sex. See, is dat stupid? Oh, Draco, Draco, I shouted, while getting an orgasm, when all of a sudden I saw a tattoo, and I had never seen before on Draco's arm. It was a black heart with an arrow through it. On it, in bloody goth writing, were the words, Vampire. I was so angry. You bastard, I shouted angrily, jumping out of bed.
No, no, but you don't understand, Draco pleaded.
But she knew too much.
No, you f***ing idiot, I shouted. You probably have AIDS anyway. I put on my clothes all huffily and then stomped out. Draco ran out, even though he was naked. He had a really big you-know-what, but I was too mad to care. I stomped out and did so until I was in the vampire's classroom, where he was having a lesson with Professor Snape and some other people. Vampire Potter, you mother f***. Chapter 8. Author's note. Stop flassing, okay? If you do, then you are a prep. Everyone in the class stared at me, and then Draco came into the room, even though he was naked, and started begging me to take him back.
Ebony, it's not what you think, he screamed sadly.
My friend Bloody Mary Smith smiled at me understandingly. She flipped her long, waist-length, gothic black hair and opened her crimson eyes like blood that she was wearing contact lenses on. She had pale white skin that she was wearing white makeup on. Hermione was kidnapped when she was born. Her real parents are vampires, and one of them is a witch, but Voldemort killed her mother and her father committed suicide because he was depressed about it. She still has nightmares about it, and she is very haunted and depressed. It also turns out her real last name is Smith and not Granger. Since she had converted to Satanism, she is in Slytherin now, not Gryffindor.
What is it that you desire, you ridiculous dimwit? Snape demeaned angrily in his cold voice, but I ignored him.
Vampire, I can't believe you cheated on me with Draco, I shouted at him.
I don't know why Ebony was so mad at me. I went out with Vampire. I'm bi, and so is Ebony, for a while, but then he broke my heart. He dumped me because he liked Brittany, a stupid preppy f***er. We're just good friends now. He'd gone through horrible problems, and now he was gothic. Haha, like I would hang out with a prep.
But I'm not going out with Draco anymore, said Vampire.
Yeah, f***ing right. F*** off, you bastard, I screamed. I ran out of the room into the Forbidden Forest, where I had lost my virility to Draco, and then I started to bust into tears. Chapter 9. Author's note. Stop flaming, okay? I didn't read all the books. This is from the movie, okay? So it's not my fault if Dumbledore swears. Besweeds, I said he had a headache. And the reason Snap doesn't like Harry now is because he's Christian and Vampire is a Satanist. My Chemical Romance rocks. I was so mad and sad, I couldn't believe Draco for cheating on me. I began to cry against the tree where I did it with Draco. Then, all of a sudden, an horrible man with red eyes and no nose and everything started flying towards me on a broomstick. He didn't have a nose, basically like Voldemort in the movie, and he was wearing all black, but it was obvious he wasn't gothic. It was Voldemort! No, I shouted in a scared voice, but then Voldemort shouted,
Imperius!
And I couldn't run away. Crookshanks, I shouted at him. Voldemort fell off his broom and started to scream. I felt bad for him, even though I'm a sadist, so I stopped.
Ebony, I yelled, thou must kill Vampire Potter!
I thought about Vampire and his six-hour eyes. And his gothic black hair, and how his face looks just like Joel Madden. I remember that Draco had said I didn't understand, so I thought, what if Draco went out with Vampire before I went out with him and they broke up? No, Voldemort, I shouted back. Voldemort gave me a gun. No, please, I begged.
Thou must, I yelled. If thou dost not, then I shall kill thy beloved Draco.
How did he know? I asked in a surprised way.
Voldemort got a dude, you're so retarded look on his face.
I hath telekinesis, he answered cruelly. And if you doth not kill Vampire, then thou know what will happen to Draco, he shouted. Then he flew away angrily on his broomstick.
I was so scared and mad I didn't know what to do. Suddenly, Draco came into the woods. Draco, I said, hi.
Hi, he said back, but his face was all sad. He was wearing white foundation and messy eyeliner, kind of like a pantogram. Get it? Between Joel Madden and Gerard Way.
Are you okay? I asked.
No, he answered.
I'm sorry I got all mad at you. But I thought you cheated on me, I expelled.
That's okay, he said all depressed, and we went back into Hogwarts together making out.
Chapter 10. Author's note. Stop it, you gay Fs. If you do not like my story, then f*** off. P.S. It turns out Bloody Mary isn't a muggle, a furt owl, and she a vampire are evil. That's why they moved houses, okay?
Okay. I was really scared about Voldemort all day. I was even upset, went to rehearsals with my gothic metal band Bloody Gothic Rose 666. Draco and Vampire were depressed, so they weren't coming, and we wrote songs instead. I knew Draco was probably slitting his wrists. He wouldn't die because he was a vampire too, and the only way you can kill a vampire is with a C-R-O-S-S. There's no way I'm writing that. Or a steak. And Vampire was probably watching a depressing movie like The Corpse Bride. I put on a black leather shirt that showed off my boobs, and tiny matching miniskirt that said Simple Plan on the butt. You might think I'm a slut, but I'm really not. We were singing a cover of Helena, and at the end of the song, I suddenly bust into tears.
Ebony, are you okay?
Bloody Mary asked in a concerted voice.
What the fuck do you think? I asked angrily. And then I said, well, Voldemort came, and the f***ing bastard told me to f***ing kill Harry. But I don't want to kill him, because he's really nice, even if he did go out with Draco. But if I don't kill Harry, then Voldemort will kill Draco. I burst into tears. Suddenly, Draco jumped out from behind a wall.
Why didn't you fucking tell me? I shouted. How could you? You fucking poser muggle bitch. C is dead out of character.
I started to cry and cry. Draco started to cry too, all sensitive. Then he ran out crying. We practiced for one more hour. Then suddenly, Dumbledore walked in angrily. His eyes were all fiery, and I knew this time it wasn't because he had a headache.
What have you done? He started to cry wisely.
See, that's basically not swearing, and this time he was really upset, and you will see why.
Ebony Draco has been found in his room. He committed suicide by slitting his wrists! What?!
Chapter 11. Author's note. I said stop flaming, you preps. See if this chapter are stupid, 11111, I delves with really serious issues. See for yourself if it's stupid, BRW fangs to my friend Raven for helping me. No, I screamed. I was horrified. Baloody Mary tried to comfort me, but I told her to fuck off. And I ran to my room crying to myself. Dumbledore chased after me, shouting, but he had to stop when I went to my room because he would look like a perv that way if he went in. Anyway, I started crying tears of blood, and then I slit both my wrists. They got all over my clothes, so I took them off and jumped into the bath angrily while I went to put on Linkin Park at full volume. I grabbed a stake and almost stuck it into my heart to commit suicide. I was so fucking depressed. I got out of the bathtub and put on a black low-cut dress with lace all over it, sandly. What? I put on black high heels with pink middle stuff on the ends and six pairs of skull earrings. I couldn't believe this. Then I looked out the window and screamed. Snap was spying on me and he was taking a videotape of me and Lupin was masticating to it. They were... masticating is chewing, by the way.
Yep, that's... yep.
And they were sitting on their broomsticks. Ooh, you f***ing pervs. Stop looking at me naked. Are you pedos or what? I screamed, putting a black towel on with a picture of Marilyn Manson on it. Suddenly, Vampire ran in.
Abracadabra! He yelled at Snape and Lupin, pointing his womb. I took my gun and shot Snape and Lupin a gazillion times, and they both started screaming, and the camera broke. Suddenly, Dumbledore ran in.
Ebony, it has been revealed that someone has... No!
He shouted, looking at Snape and Lupin, and then waved his wand. And suddenly...
Hagrid ran outside on his broom and said, Everyone, we need to talk. What do you know, Hagrid? You're just a little Hogwarts student.
I may be a Hogwarts student, Hagrid paused angrily. But I am also a Satanist!
This cannot be, Snap said in a crisp voice, as blood dripped from his hand where Dumbledore's wand had shot him. What? What? Dude, I'm beyond lost at this point. There must be other factors.
You don't have any, I yelled in madly.
Lupin held up the camera, triumphantly.
The lens may be ruined, but the tape is still there.
I felt faint, more than I normally do, like how it feels when you do not drink enough blood.
Why are you doing this?
Lupin said angrily.
Because,
Hagrid said as he paused in the air dramatically, waving his wand in the air. Then swooped he in, singing to the tune of a gothic version of a song by 50 Cent.
Because you're gothic?
Snap asked in a little afraid voice, because he was afraid it meant he was connected with Satan.
Because I love her!
Chapter 12, author's note. Stop F, R-ing, okay? Hagrid is a pedo to a lot of people in American schools. Like that, I wanted to address the issue. How do you know Snap
I and Kristen plus Hagrid isn't really in love with Ebony. That was Cedric, okay? I was about to slit my wrists again with a silver knife that Draco had given me in case anything happened to him.
No!
I thought it was Hagrid, but it was Vampire. He started to scream.
Oh my fucking god, no! My scar hurts!
And then his eyes rolled up. You could only see his red whites. I stopped. How did you know?
I saw it, and my scar turned back into a lightning bolt!
No! I ran up closer. I thought you didn't have a scar anymore, I shouted.
I do, but Diabolo changed it into a pentagram for me, and I always cover it up with foundation, I said back. Anyway, my scar hurt and it turned back into the lightning bolt! Save me!
Then I had a vision of what was happening to Draco. Voldemort has him bondage! Anyway, I was in the school nurse's office now, recovering from my slit wrists. Snap and Lupin and Harit was there too. They were going to St. Mango's after they recovered, because there were pedophiles, and you can't have those f***ing pervs teaching in a school with lots of hot girls. Dumbledore had constipated the Sidio camera they took off me naked. I put up my middle finger at them. Anyway, Hagrid came into the hospital bed holding a bouquet of pink roses.
Inobi, I need to tell you something, Ig, I said in a V-serious voice, giving her the roses.
F*** off, I told him. You know I hate the f***ing color pink anyway, and I don't like f***ed up preps like you, I snapped. Hagrid had been mean to me before for being gothic.
No, Inobi, Hagrid says, those are not roses.
What, are they goths too, you poser prep? I asked because I was angry that he had bought me pink roses.
I saved your life, I yelled angrily.
No you didn't, I replied. You saved me from getting a Paris Hilton pee video made from your shower scene and being viewed by Snape and Lupin, who masturbated. See, is that spelled wrong? Whatever, I yelled angrily. He pointed his wand at the pink roses.
These aren't roses. He suddenly looked at them with an evil look in his eye and muttered, well, if you wanted honesty, that's all you had to say.
That's not a spell. That's a My Chemical Romance song, I corrected him wisely.
I know. I was just warming up my vocal cordes. Then he screamed, Petulus Marengo mi gremil gil romasio.
For all you cool gothic My Chemical Romance fans out there, that is a tribute. Especially for Raven. I love you, girl. In my opinion, Nato Okeo.
And then the roses turned into a huge black flame floating in the middle of the air. And it was black. And I knew he wasn't a prep. Okay, I believe you now. What the fuck is Draco?
Hagrid rolled his eyes. I looked into the balls of flame, but I could see nothing.
You see, Inobi, Dumbledore said, watching the two of us watching the flame. To see what is into flames. Ha ha ha, you reviewers flames, get it? You must find yourself first, Kay. No, I have find myself okay, you mean old man, Hagrid yelled. Dumbledore looked shocked. I guess he didn't have a headache, or else he would have said something back. Hagrid stormed off back into his bed.
Anyway, when I got better, I went upstairs and put on a black leather mini dress that was all ripped on the ends with lace on it. Then I put on some corset stuff on the front, then I put on some black fishnets and black high-heeled boots with pictures of Billy Joe Armstrong on them. I put my hair all out around me so I looked like Samara from The Ring. If you don't know who she is, you are prep, so f*** off. So I put on blood red lipstick, black eyeliner, and black lip gloss.
You look kawaii, girl.
But Ludie Mary said sadly.
Fangs, get it? You do too, I said sadly. But I was still upset. I slit both my wrists, feeling totally depressed, and I sucked out all the blood. I cried again in my bathroom, and I put the shades on so Snap and Lupin couldn't spy on me this time. I went to some classes.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
Vampire was in the hair of magic creatures. He looked all depressed because Draco had disappeared, and he had used to be in love with Draco. He was sucking some blood from a Hufflepuff.
Hi, he said in a depressed way.
Hi back, I said in a wickerily sad way. We both looked at each other for some time. Harry had beautiful red gothic eyes, so much like Draco's. Then, we jumped on each other and started screwing each other.
Stop it now, you horny simpletons!
Shouted Professor McGoggle, who was watching us, and so was everyone else.
Vampire, you f***er, I started slapping him. Stop trying to screw me. You know I love Draco, I shouted, then I ran away angrily. Chapter 13. Vampire and I run up the stairs looking for Dumbledore. We were so scared.
Dumbledore! Dumbledore!
We both yelled. Dumbledore came there.
What is it that you want now, you despicable snobs?
He asked angrily.
Voldemort has Draco!
We shouted at the same time. He laughed in an evil voice.
No! Don't! We need to save Draco!
We begged.
No, he said meanly. I don't give a darn what Voldemort does to Draco. Not after how much he misbehaved in school, especially with you, Ebony, he said while he frowned looking at me. Besides, I never liked him that much anyway. Then he walked away. Vampire started crying.
My Draco!
He moaned.
Author's note. Don't you think gay guys are, like, so hot? It's okay. I tried to help him, but that didn't stop him. He started to cry tears of blood. And then he had a brainstorm.
I had an idea! He exclaimed.
What? I asked him.
You'll see, he said. He took out his wand and did a spell. Then, suddenly, we were in Voldemort's lair!
We ran with our wands out, just as we heard the croon voice say, Allah Kadavra. It was Voldemort. Chapter 14. Author's note. F off preps, okay? Raven Fangs for helping again. I'm sorry I couldn't update, but I was depressed and had to go to the hospital because I slit my wrists. P.S. I'm not updating till I give you my 10 good reviews. Warning, some of this chapter is extremely scray. Vior excretion advised. We ran into where Voldemort was. It turned out that Voldemort wasn't there. Instead, the fat guy who killed Cedric was. Draco was there crying tears of blood. Snaketail was torturing him.
People live their authentic lives.
Vampire and I ran in front of the Snaketail.
Read my sight, you despicable preps! He shouted as we started shooting him with the gun. He then suddenly, he looked at me, and he fell down with a lovey-dovey look in his eyes.
Doc, he said.
In dis, he is 16 years old, so he's not a pedophile, okay?
Huh? I asked.
Inobi, I love you. Will you have sex with me? Asked Snaketail.
I started laughing crudely. What the fuck? You torture my boyfriend and then you expect me to f*** you? God, you are so f***ed up, you f***ing bastard, I said angrily. And then I stabbed him in the heart. Blood poured out like a fountain.
No!
He screamed. He started screaming and running around. Then he fell down and died. I burst into tears sadly.
Snaketail, what art thou doing? Called Voldemort.
Then, he started coming. We could hear his high heels clacking to us. So we got on our broomsticks and we flew to Hogwarts. We went to my room. Vampire went away. There I started crying. What's wrong, honey? Asked Draco, taking off his clothes so we could screw.
He had a sex pack. Get it? Because he's so sexy. and a really huge you-know-what and everything. It's so unfair, I yielded. Why can't I just be ugly or plain like all the other girls and preps here except for Baludi Mary? Because she's not ugly or anything.
Why would you want to be ugly? I don't like the preps anyway. They're such f***ing sluts, answered Draco.
Yeah, but everyone is in love with me. Like Snape and Lupin took a video of me naked. Hagrid says he's in love with me. Vampires like me, and now even Snaketail is in love with me. I just want to be with you, okay, Draco? Why couldn't Satan have made me less beautiful? I shouted angrily. Author's note. Don't worry, Inobi isn't a snob or anything, but a lot of people have told her she's pretty. I'm good at too many things. Why can't I just be normal? It's a f***ing curse. I shouted and then I ran away.
Chapter 15. Author's note. Stop flaming, okay? By the way, you suck from no on every time someone flams me, I'm gonna slit my wrists. Fangs to Raven for helping.
Ebony! Ebony! Shouted Draco sadly. No, please, come back!
But I was too mad. Whatever, now you can go and have sex with Vampire, I shouted. I stormed into my room and closed my black door with the blood-red key. Then I looked at my black Good Charlotte watch and noticed that it was time to go to biology.
I put on a short, ripped black gothic dress that said Anarchy on the front in blood-red letters, and it was all ripped and with a spiky belt. Under that, I put on ripped black fishnets and boots that said Joel all over them in blood-red letters. I put my ebony black hair out. Anyway, I went downstairs, feeling all sad and depressed as usual. I did some advanced biology work. I was turning a bloody pentagram into a black guitar. Suddenly, the guitar turned to Draco.
Inobi, I love you, I shouted sadly. I do not care what those fucker preps and posers think. You're the most beautiful girl in the world. Before I met you, I used to want to commit suicide all the time. Now I just want to fucking be with you. I fucking love you.
Then he started to sing The Chronicles of Life and Death. We considered it our song now, because we fell in love when Joel was singing it. Oh my f***ing god, I said after he was finished. Some f***ing preps stared at us, but I just stuck my middle finger up at them. They were covered in black nail polish, and were intertwined with Draco's now. I love you, I said, and then we started to kiss. Then we went away holding hands. Lupin shouted at us, but he stopped because everyone was clapping by how sexy we looked together. Then I saw a poster saying that MCR would have a concert in Hogsmeade right then. We looked at each other all shocked, and then we went together.
To be continued. Question mark? Like bloody question mark. Next time on My Immortal. Ebony and Draco go to the My Chemical Romance concert. But they're in for a big surprise.